Hey everyone, it's Peter here. In this video, I'm going to go through the most important slider settings with you. When you enter Smart Slider, you get to the dashboard, what you can see now. This is where you can start creating new projects and you can also find the existing ones. Let's move on to the slider settings. To find the available options, just click on the slider you want to edit. First, I want to show you the interface. This is the breadcrumb navigation, which you can always use to go back to the dashboard. With the Add Slide button, you can create new slides. The already created slides are on the slide panel. In the preview, you can always take a look at how your slider looks, even if you haven't saved your settings yet. With these buttons, you can go back to the dashboard or save the settings of the slider. Under the top bar, you can find the slider-related actions, like the Export, Duplicate Slider, or Move to Trash. This is what you need to know about the interface. Let's see the settings of the slider. The General tab contains the most basic settings of the slider and the publishing options. You can publish your slider with its shortcode or PHP code, but you can find the Smart Slider 3 module in many popular page builders as well. A good name and thumbnail image can help you find your slider easily in the dashboard. A slider can have a background which stays behind the slides. With this, you can create a static background to have moving slides over it. Switch to the Size tab to find the size-related settings. The base size of the slider comes from the slider size value. With the Limit Slide Width option, the maximum width of the slides will be equal to the set slider width. Because of this, the height of the slider won't grow too big. If you turn it off, then the width of the slide will always be the width of the slider, so the height will grow too. As you can see on my example, this slider has a much bigger height, as it doesn't use the slide width limitation. The breakpoints are defining the screen width, where the slider should display the desktop, tablet, and mobile views. The layout decides the size of the slider on the front end of the website. Boxed sliders fill the place where you put them. Full width sliders fill up the width of the whole page. Full page sliders fill up the entire page horizontally and vertically. While usually there's no need for custom mobile or tablet sizes, you can set them here. The controls are elements on the slider, which help switching slides. Use the arrows to browse the slider from slide to slide. With thumbnails, you can select any slide you like. Using text bar is a quick way of having captions on the slides. Bullets represent the available slides and you can use them for navigation. Once you turn on the control you want to use, you can customize it in any way. The colors and similar settings can be reached with the style buttons. A lot of cool effects like the slide transitions and parallax effects can be found on the Animations tab. The main animation defines how the slide transition looks. For example, it can be horizontal sliding, or simple fading. With the carousel option, your slider can loop. By turning off the carousel option, the slider will have a beginning and an end. The background animation and Ken Burns effect can create spectacular effects on the background images of the slide. The background animation happens on the background images, while the main animation moves the layers. The Ken Burns effect moves and scales the background image. The shape divider and the particle effect appear on the entire slider. This wave effect is one of the shape dividers you can choose. It appears on the bottom of the slider, but it's possible to add the shape divider to the top as well. The particle effect is these little dots you can see moving over the slider. At the bottom you can find the layer-related animation settings, like the layer parallax. The mouse parallax effect is based on the mouse cursor position on the slider area. The scrolling parallax is visible when you scroll on the page. The autoplay is a timer which moves the slides automatically with the given interval. The Optimize tab contains options which can make your slider load faster, like lazy loading. With the optimized slide images, the background images will be resized to the size of the slider. On the Loading tab, you can find the options which are related to the loading of the slider. With Loading Type, you can choose whether the slider should load with the page or partially after the selected event. The Slides tab contains the settings which affect all slides. Slide Background Image Fill is how the background images fill up the slides. With the Randomize option, you can display the slides in a random order. If you have a background image on all of the slides, with the Background in Lightbox option, you can easily create lightboxes from them. The Background Parallax moves the background images with a nice effect during page scrolling. Lastly, on the Developer tab, you can find some useful options for developers. I hope you learned something new by watching this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want more awesome tutorial videos, then subscribe to our channel. Goodbye!